how to create an MCAT study plan. So, you are gearing up to tackle the MCAT, the 8-hour beast of a test that could determine the fate of your medical school applications, but where do you even begin? And what separates a top scorer from just an average one? Well, we're going to go over all of that in this video, but first, hit that subscribe button to join our pre-med community and ring the bell so that you never miss a video with MCAT tips and med school admissions advice. The AAMC recommends pre-med study for at least 300-ish hours, and most students will spread that out over 3 to 6 months. Now, studying for the MCAT includes a good amount of content review, practice questions, taking full-length practice exams, and reviewing all of those practice questions and tests. As you can imagine, there's a lot of material to cover on the MCAT and a ton of resources and data that you need to keep track of to get ready for test day. That's why each and every MCAT student needs to create a balanced and effective study plan. But no two MCAT students are alike, so let's break down exactly how to create your own study plan and what it needs to include. Now, you could make your life a little bit easier by letting us do all of the hard work for you by using our free customizable MCAT study planner. The link for that is in the description below. But if you are set on making your own, follow these steps. Step number one, take an MCAT diagnostic test. Just do it, just take it, okay? A diagnostic test can help you identify where you're starting from and where you need to focus your energy. If you need one, check out that description below for a free diagnostic test on us. Step number two, plan your content review, okay? A proper MCAT study plan needs time to go over all of the content that will be on the test. However, it is incredibly easy to fall into a rabbit hole if you dedicate significant amounts of time to studying everything equally. Identify what the high yield topics are and what topics you haven't had much of a background in. Remember, it's not just about memorizing facts, it's about understanding concepts and making connections. Step number three, plan your practice. The biggest mistake that MCAT students make is dedicating tons of hours over many weeks to content review and then saving practice for the very end. Look, don't do that, okay? Don't even think about doing that. Engaging in practice will help you apply your content knowledge. The MCAT is not just a memorization test, okay? Doing active studying and practice will help you better understand how concepts tie together and how you need to improve and potentially switch up your test. Step number four, schedule those full-length practice tests. Okay, full-length exams are a non-negotiable part of your MCAT study plan. Not only are they going to test your knowledge, but they'll also help you develop strategies that you'll rely on test day. And hey, remember how the exam is nearly 8 hours long? Look, you can't just expect your brain to handle that much stress overnight. Full-length practice exams are essential for building your endurance and stamina. Step number five, schedule review days. Look, after you've taken a practice exam, set aside an entire day to review that test. Your practice tests are filled with insights about your performance and your progress. You should be keeping a lessons learned journal to keep track of your mistakes and the lessons that you've learned from them. Step number six, schedule those breaks. We don't expect you to prep every single day. In fact, we don't want you to. Schedule at least one day off every single week where you literally do anything that is not MCAT prep. And make sure you take breaks during your daily study sessions as well. MCAT burnout is real, so please take care of your mental health. A healthy and refreshed mind is your best tool for the test. Honestly, that's mostly it. If you can stay organized and consistent, you'll be well on your way to your goal MCAT score. You've got this.